In this Procreate Dreams tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to use keyframing, gestures, easing, frame-by-frame animation, and many more useful tools. Basically everything you need to start animating in Procreate Dreams. When creating a new project, you're going to want to click on the little plus icon in the top right corner. Then you're going to select one of the 5 movie sizes. I recommend using screen size for anything unprofessional. Click on the 3 little dots for whatever aspect ratio you chose to then change the duration and frames per second. Click on the 4K button to change the resolution. Also, if you're on an older iPad, then you may experience some glitches using 2 or 4K. I'm on the base 9th generation iPad, and the app froze up 4 times in the 3 hours that I've been using it. I was using it at 4K, so I do recommend using 1080p, say, for an older iPad. I ended up having to close the app each time. I didn't lose anything, but it's definitely not ideal. Now that you have your Procreate Dreams project open, you're going to want to know how to navigate it. So first off, the bottom of the screen is where you can edit your tracks. A track is like a layer in Procreate. If you want to edit any of the settings for your project, click on the name of your project. If you didn't name it, then it will be called Dream 1. Here you can change any of the settings like aspect ratio, frames per second. This is also where you can export your project when you're finished with it. Click Done when you're done messing with the settings. When you want to leave your project, click on the 4 square icon and that will bring you back to the menu. If you swipe to the sides with 3 fingers while you're on your tracks, you can zoom in and out on those tracks. Alternatively, you can use 2 fingers to zoom in and out, though it's less accurate. To zoom in directly onto a track, just tap with 2 fingers on that track. Also, when zoomed in on your tracks, that small section that you're zoomed in on will loop. To zoom out, you can either fling the playhead to the left and it will zoom out and restart your animation, or you can pinch just like in Procreate to fit the tracks to your screen. You can undo any mistakes you make or any changes you don't like by tapping on the screen with 2 fingers. Likewise, if you accidentally undo something, or if you change your mind about something you undid, you can redo it by tapping on the screen with 3 fingers. If you want to preview your animation in full screen, then tap with 4 fingers on your animation. Now you can tap with 1 finger to bring up the play button, and you can also scrub through your animation with your finger. If you swipe up or down with 3 fingers, then you can scale your tracks, making it easier to add keyframes when animating, which leads me to... If you've never animated before, then think of keyframes as important markers in an animation timeline. They're like key moments where you define how something should look or move at a specific time. Let's say you're animating a bouncing ball. You'd set keyframes at certain points, like at the start when the ball is on the ground, another keyframe a bit higher when it's in the air, and another when it hits the ground again. Each keyframe holds information about the ball's position, size, or any other changes you want to happen at that exact moment. Then the computer fills in the in-between frames to create the smooth motion from one keyframe to another. It's like giving the computer a map of important points, and it figures out how to connect them smoothly. To add a keyframe, tap on the clapboard icon, the thing Procreate calls a playhead. It lets you scrub through the timeline. Clicking on it brings up a menu with 3 categories: Move, Filter, and Edit. Edit lets you split whatever you're working on. Filter lets you animate the opacity, add Gaussian blur, basically everything you can do with the magic wand in Procreate. And finally, the Move button lets you move, scale, warp, and distort. Move and scale being the main one. So tap on the Move and Scale icon, that adds a keyframe. Then move further down the timeline to where you want your movement to end. Tap on the faded Move and Scale icon, this adds a new keyframe. Now you can move what you have selected. You can distort it by pushing or pulling on the edges of your selection, or you can make it smaller by using the dots on the corners of the selection. To rotate your selection, tap on one of the corner dots and move around the little curved line. Easing is an important part of keyframing, as it allows you to vary the movement speed of your tracks. To add easing, hold down on the mini track with the keyframes to your track. Make sure not to hold down on a keyframe. Do it in between or after keyframes. Now, click on Set All Easings. There are 4 options. Linear means it won't vary the speed at all, which can look pretty unnatural, but does have some good use cases. Ease In means it will start out slow. Ease Out means it will end slowly. And Ease In and Out starts slow, speeds up, and ends slow. Thank you so much for making it so far into my video. I really appreciate it. Feel free to leave a like on this video. It helps a lot. Or you can comment an idea for a future video. I do take it into consideration. And finally, subscribing would be great. Thank you, and on with the video. To start animating using the flipbook, you'll need to make a new track. To do so, click on the little plus icon, then track. Now that you have your new track, go to the draw and paint icon. Click on that, and a little line will have appeared in the middle of the screen. Swipe up or down on it, it doesn't matter, and it will open the flipbook. Here, you can switch between frames, draw on each one, and have frame-by-frame animation. To help out with that, you can turn on onion skin. Onion skin lets you see the previous layers so you can make your animation smoother. To turn it on, click on the timestamp in the bottom left corner, then toggle on onion skin. The main attraction of Procreate Dreams is the new and innovative Perform mode. It mimics the movement you do on a track with your finger or Apple Pencil. To use it, click on the little circle. Now you can move your selection and keyframes will be created. When you enter Perform mode, the Modify button will become visible at the top of the screen. It's the equivalent of streamlining in Procreate. And generally, it's a good idea to keep it at the default 30%. However, if you're doing something that requires fast movements, turning the motion filtering down to zero will help a lot.